Hey everyone, I want to show you a thing I made with Prisma. It's a small little booking app called Tomorrow, which allows you to schedule classes and accept payments online. So I'll go for a quick demo of the app, and then I'm going to go for a quick coding demonstration of some of the technical constraints I faced whilst building the app. So here you can see on the left, you have a bunch of classes which repeat on a schedule, and then you can search through the calendar for certain dates. You can add filters. So then we'll go ahead and book a boxing class, for example. Add a bunch of spaces and some details, press pay with card, and then you get booking confirmation. So one of the main issues with building this was that the events obviously run on the schedule, and you don't want to add each instance of the schedule to the database, so you need to define a rule for how it repeats. And I'm using something called the iCalendar specification to do this. But then one of the other problems is that if, for example, you wanted to cancel the event on the 13th only or modify the event's time, you need a way of adding cancellations and exceptions to the rule as well. So I'll go through a quick coding demo now of how I achieved that. So for the sake of the demo, I've already written a bunch of boilerplate code. What we have basically is a GraphQL server which will return a list of events. So the schema in Prisma to do this, we have basically an event model which contains a bunch of information about when the event will occur, for example. So the rule would actually get saved here. Then we have a bunch of exceptions and cancellations attached to the main event. Then the actual event details are saved up in a separate model here. The reason for that is because the details could change between the main event and the exceptions, and obviously we don't want to repeat the fields across separate models, so we just link it this way. So if I run the migration script, I'll add everything into the database. So here we had an empty database, and now you can see we've got it full of all those models that we just had. Then I'm going to go and seed some data. Something in. So cool, we have one event in here as well, and then we have a little rule explain when it will repeat. So inside the resolver, what we have here is a quick query which will just grab all the events from the database, and then it's running it through a utility function called expand events. This basically takes the event and it looks at the repetition rule, and it will just repeat it for whatever the rule says. So then if we launch the server and then go ahead and run a query. So here we can see that, for example, we've got a yoga event which is repeating daily, and then it's obviously the same event repeated, so all the data is identical. Now, in the case of adding an exception, we want to be able to say, for example, just change the first 2 days to happen only in the morning rather than 6 o'clock. So here we have more information about the exception. The main things are the original date and then the new date. So the original date is the date that's being replaced, and the new date is obviously what the new time is. And then that's also linked to event details, so we can change things like the title or the price for that exception as well. So if I go back into my cedar file and add some exception data, cool. So then here we have some information about an event exception. And then we also need to go and update the event inside. Where are we? Expand events, that's the one. So just to give a brief overview, the way expand events works is it's using something called rule, which is an NPM library. It's a representation of something called the iCalendar specification. Basically what we do is we pass the event in, we read the rule out, and then we print a set of dates, which between two other dates, and then we just basically spread the event over each date, so we have it all duplicated. Now, when we're working with exceptions, we need to make some small updates to this function. So here's something I wrote earlier. So the only update is that Now, when we're passing the exceptions in, we exclude all of the original dites from the dites that get printed out from our rule. And then afterwards, we can concatenate to the original array a bunch of exceptions with the exception details here. So if I save this, and then the one other thing we need to do is make sure that we're actually requesting the extra data from Prisma. So I'll save there as well. Then yarn dev, one more time, cool. So here we have now an exception to the rule, so yoga in the morning. So you can see that on the first it's at 6, then on the second it's at 9, and then on the third it's at 6 again. So that event's been replaced completely. So the one other thing that we would want to do is, rather than replace things, you just cancel things completely. So it's a very similar situation to before. We have another model called event cancellation. And here we have just the original date that we want to remove, and then just a link to the event ID that we're actually moving. So then if I go back into Cedars, and I'll add an event cancellation to the database. Cool. And then we'll go over to cancellations again. I can see that we have an entry here. So the fifth month at 6 o'clock is going to get canceled completely. And then back into the resolver. And now I need to make sure that cancellations is being fetched as well. So I'll just add an extra thing to the query. The cancellations will now come through, and then if I look in expand events again, we have another slight change to this function. So the only difference here is that now we're also mapping over the cancellations, and they're getting excluded from the outputted dates as well. So I'll save that and run the server one more time. Cool. And then do the query one more time, and then you'll notice that the fifth month has now disappeared completely from the query. And basically, yeah, that's a little demo of some of the things I did with Prisma. I've also added here a link to the GitHub repo for the demo, and thanks for listening.